ものかというと、魔人や魔獣を召喚しながら広範囲に敵を攻撃することができるという。
So what this lets you do is basically summon demons as you're attacking to really expand the area of attack.
I love seeing, especially Madama Butterfly when she comes in and steps in to help you out. It's just, it's awesome. It looks so cool.
Madama Butterfly が本当に入ってくる時がものすごいかっこいいですね。
そうですね。初めて。ですね、前作では全身が見えることはなかったんで、やっと全身を見せることができてちょっと嬉しいです、僕自身。
So this is actually I'm really excited with this because in the last game we weren't able to we didn't really show all of Madame Butterfly, but in this game you see the, her entire being.
でですね、これが前作にもあった拷問器具を召喚して敵を倒すっていうトーチャーアタックですね。
And so this was in the last game as well, called Torture Attacks, where you basically summon a torture device and are able to defeat a single enemy instantaneously.
Brutalize
them. Oh, yeah, すごいですね。
で、まあ前作にもあったそのトーチャーアタック、敵を単体で倒すのか、先ほど紹介したアンブランクライマックスですね。あれを使って敵を広範囲に攻撃するのかっていうところが、バトルのこうユーザーが自由に選べて緊張感を、まあ、高める爽快感につながる部分だったりでですね、はい。
So with the addition of Umbran Climax, the player now has the has to make a decision with the magic that they filled up. Basically, do I use it to defeat one enemy using a torture attack, or do I expand my area of attack and try to defeat all multiple enemies at once? And that's sort of a feature that we implemented so that it increases the intensity of the battles.
しかも装備している武器によって召喚する魔獣やこう魔獣が違うので、よりこう例えば手にまた違う武器をつけて、足にも違う武器をつけると、じゃあどんな組み合わせが出るのかっていうところも楽しみの一つですね。
So, you know, another thing to look forward to is depending on what weapon you're equipped with, you summon different demons. So, you know, equipping different weapons for your hands or your feet can result in different effects.
Yeah, it's really interesting how the combos line up too. Depending on which weapons you've got equipped, you could have a very different experience when you're fighting. That's one thing I really enjoyed with the first game, was mixing around with that and finding out, okay, what kind of style works right. for me. But you get so much flexibility there.
そう
ですね、まあ、今回もそれにさらに加えてアンブランクライマックスを使うとどういった効果があるのかっていうのは、またもう一段違う楽しみが一つ増えてますね。
And I think with the addition of the Umbran Climax, we're able to add another step of joy and satisfaction to the combos that you're seeing with different weapons.
It does feel really good when it's just suddenly like, I'm raining down destruction on my enemies.
そうですね。まあ、召喚できるとすごい快感がありますね。
そこだからね、僕ももっと作りたかったんですけど、結構スタッフからももういいやろみたいな感じで求められた部分もありますけどね。
So actually, I wanted to add even more summons, but the staff was like, all right, that's probably enough.
詰め込めるだけ詰め込みました。
But we packed it as much as we can.
はい。ではですね、続いて、まあ、今回 Wii U で、ベヨネッタ2を出すにあたって、Wii U ならではの特徴であるタッチ操作についてちょっと説明したいと思います。
So I'd like to get into a new feature exclusive to the Wii U, which is the touch controls for Bayonetta.
これはですね、ゲームパッドで手軽に、より気軽にゲームを楽しんでもらうためのシステムになってます。
Basically, this system allows anybody to play Bayonetta very easily and very casually.
まあ、簡単に説明すると、タッチをこう敵にするとマーカーみたいなのが出るんですね。あれにするとベヨネッタが普通に攻撃してくれます。
So what,
敵をしてます。
So as you see here, you're fighting an angel on top of a train. If you look behind, the bridge is constantly collapsing, the train's getting beat up, and this is kind of an intense moment where you don't know, you know, it's hard to keep up with what's going on. But even then,We try to make sure that you're able to really play. It doesn't sacrifice any of the playability and the control scheme that is just right.
And when you're playing and you're deep in the action, you might not realize this, but when you're just watching the game, looking in the background, there's such detail there as far as like this whole city skyline that's rushing by as you're on top of a moving train fighting a giant angel.
こんなクライマックスシーンでプレイしてるときは気づかないかもしれませんけど、本当背景もすごい美しい背景になっていて、すごいディテールがありますよね。
そうですね。これ 例えばプレイしてる人だけじゃなくって、やはり一緒に見てる人が楽しめる内容のシチュエーションをどうするかっていうところに注目してもらえればなと思います。
You know, yeah, like you mentioned, I'd really like to encourage people who are just watching or aren't playing to really enjoy the detail that's been put into all of the background.
で、今回ですね、よりオンラインでみんなと楽しむためのこう協力プレイっていうのが入ってるんですけど、まあ、それをちょっと今回はお見せすることができないんですが、雰囲気的にこういった感じだよっていう、風なこれたベオとベオネッタと、まあ、親友のジャンヌがこう2人で敵を倒すっていうのも、まあ、大体こう協力プレイっていうのはこういった形のプレイを想像してもらえればなと思います。
So in Bayonetta 2, a new feature is the ability to play co-op online, and unfortunately we're not able to show that today at this Nintendo Treehouse Live at E3. However, we wanted to show this portion of the game because this is what it sort of looks like, where you're battling an enemy with two different characters on screen.
And it's great to see Jean back here as well. She's got a really cool redesign going on as well.
Yeah, Jean が戻ってきてくれてすごい嬉しいですね。
そうなんです。僕、ベヨネッタのショートヘアにこうなったんですけど、ジャンヌのその髪の毛長いジャンヌが大好きなんですよ。
You know, so Bayonetta, she obviously has a short hair look now, but I really like Jean's long hair look too.
I feel like this poor monster doesn't stand a chance. I feel bad for him a little bit.
モンスターが気の毒に言
う。そうなんですよね。前まではこう一人であんだけなんですけど、今度二人であそこまでこう殴られたりとかすると、やはりああいった見た目になるのかなっていう感じはします
よ。You know, so being punished by two witches, I would imagine they would look like that, just kind of pummeled.
で、まあ先ほども紹介したんですけど、クラスの高い時にはああいった形でこう魔獣を召喚して、フィニッシュはあります。大魔獣召喚ですね。
And like I mentioned, for tougher enemies, she'll summon stronger demons to finish them off, like this one here.
And on the subject of enemies, I'd love to chat a bit about the design scheme for the enemies, because you guys went in a really interesting direction here with the design, especially of the angels, compared to what we saw in Bayonetta.
前回の天使たちのデザインの違いにも違いがあったので、それについてもお話しいただけますでしょうか。
悪魔の方ですかね。
Are you talking about demons or angels?
Well, I was thinking I think it's the angels who have the more, like, not so much of the bird motif that they had before, but also the demons too. They're both really awesome.
実はね、天使の方は前作で僕デザインもしつくしちゃってたんで、すごいこう、もう今回大変だったんですよ。難産で。
You know, I really feel like I did my best and gave it everything I had in the last game, so it's very difficult to come up with new ideas for the angels.
でそこでこうどうしようかなと思ってて、馬天使、馬の形の天使になりましたね、今回。
And so after that, after struggling a bit, we decided to go with the horse-based angels instead of the birds last game.
もうちょっと説明を天使の方にしちゃいすぎたんで、話を戻すんですけど、これ、先ほど召喚した大魔獣のゴモラが暴走するんですね。この暴走するのは、非常にこうストーリーが重要に関わってきます。
So to kind of go back with what's going on the screen, Basically, what's happened is Gomora, the demon that she summoned, is actually loose now and attacking her. And this concept of the demon becoming loose and attacking her plays an important role in the storyline of the game.
で、やはりですね、ここ見てもらったら分かるんですけど、先ほど地上じゃなくて今空中のシチュエーションですよね。これはやはり今回2を作るにあたって、3D 空間をフル活用した、まあ、シチュエーションは何かっていうところに重点を置いた形で制作しました。
So as you can see here, compared to the earlier battle, she's actually flying around, battling this demon. And so when we, thought about how we can improve and evolve this game, we thought about how can we use the 3D, world that's within Bayonetta to its fullest. And we came up with the idea of, including aerial battles in this game.
ただですね、通常の Tokyo とまたこう操作が全然こう違うっていうことではなくて、地上から空中になってるんですけど、まあ、違和感なく操作してよりバトルを楽しめるっていう形にしてます。
But you know, just because it's an aerial battle doesn't mean that it sacrifices any of the maneuverability that Bayonetta has or the smooth action.
So it's all seamless. 攻撃を避けていってもらってもいいですか。こういった形でゴモラ自身も、まあ、あそこにちょっと捕まってるんですけど、こういったこうダイナミックなシチュエーション、これ食べられるかもしれないですけど、ね。
So, you know, we try to make it as much dynamic, dynamism as possible.
マジンを召喚して、こう、そこの動きを止めて、あの、攻撃するっていう。
You know, she would summon the demon just to pry open the demon's mouth to pummel him again.
Yeah, it's crazy. Like, I mean, how much... This looks like a cinematic, but you're actually moving around and playing in it, but it's...It blends so well into like everything that's just going on around it. It's really intense fight.
カットシーンのような見た目なんですけど、やっぱ実際にこう操作してプレイしてるというのはすごいですね。
そうですね。だから映画の本当クライマックスシーンをよりあのインタラクティブに楽しめるかっていうところに重点を置いてます。
So we put a large focus on how we can create those cinematic climax scenes like you see in movies, and how we can make that playable and interactive.
でこの、 あのゴムランのモデルなんですけど実はうちの会社でもこう指折りの大型のモデルを作らせたら都合で の、 そのデザイナーですねにあの作ってもらってます
So、actually the designer who designed、Gomorrah the demon here he's actually one of our company's best、designers for big models like this
Oh, he just looks so creepy
Yeah,
so cool.
怖いですね
怖いですね。ここ僕まず好きなシーンなんですよね。
And this is another scene I really, really enjoy and like.
まあ全部好きなんですけどね。
I mean, I like all of them, but, you know.
It's like you really do get a sense of Gomorrah's scale here. It's just so huge.
やっぱ本当にゴモラのスケールがわかりますね。
そうですね。で、やはりこれがきっかけで、まあどういった形でストーリーはどうなるのかっていうところも、まあ興味深い部分なんで、あのその辺も楽しみにしてもらえたらなっていうのと、まあ、ここのこれ空中になってるんですけど空中でもアンブランクライマックスを使って攻撃することが、まあ、できるんですね。
And yeah, not only the scale, you know, what happens here within the Gomorrah fight scene plays, like I mentioned before, plays a really important role in the storyline. So that's something that I really like the audience at home to really look forward to.And like on the ground, she's able to use Umbran Climax even when she's flying.
これみんなゴモラあの口だけになってると思うんですけど、頭が実はあそこなんですよね。
So you might not notice, but he has a big mouth, and his head is actually just that white portion on top.
はい。まあ気づいてる人は少ないと思うんですけど。
I don't think a lot of people really notice that.
Oh, the little glowing eyes are super creepy.
光ってる目が怖いですね。
そうですね。バトルの方行ってみましょうか。
Alright, so let's move forward with the battle.
And I don't know if folks noticed what we were doing an earlier battle here was the poor angel was getting his butt kicked. And I don't know if folks had a chance to like see him too still, but his face was actually in his sword. And some of those little design details, like I love these guys all feel very unique and you get a good sense of a very diverse world.Even like, you know, you may be a demon, you may be an angel, but even within that, there's such a stretch of the different kind of looks and some really creepy stuff in their designs.
先ほどのあの天使のバトルでもあの見てご覧になってる皆さん気づかなかったかもしれませんけど、あの剣顔が剣についてたりとか、いろんな天使とあの悪魔であっても、あの、はい、魔獣であっても、いろんなみんな一人ずつこの個性なものがあって、すごいあのいろんなあのバラエティーが。
そうですね、やはりデザインの部分でもこう一度見たら忘れないっていうようなところには結構気を使ってデザインしてる部分ではあります。
So in terms of design, we really try to make sure that you know all of these monsters and enemy characters are ones that you look at it once and you won't forget again.
Yeah, you wouldn't forget that anytime soon.
Yeah, 忘れられない。
そうですね、まあデザインも込みなんですけどこの。クライマックスのシチュエーションを例えば画面写真をパッて雑誌とかで見た時もわっすごいっていうようなで見ても面白いこうやっても面白いっていうところはあの非常に重点を置いてるとこですしさらに動いてるシチュエーションを見るとよりあのおってなるっていうようなところにはあのクライマックスっていうシチュエーションを作る上でものすごく気を使った部分ですね。
And you know, like I mentioned before, we really try to emphasize the fact that, you know, this game is...